The Office of the Ombudsman slaps a six-month preventive suspension against Cebu City Mayor Michael Rama and seven other officials. Our correspondent Robert Mano now on the line for more on that. Robert?
Ron, in a 10-page resolution signed by Ombudsman Samuel Martirez, it is stated that there is a strong evidence against the Cebu City officials who were complained of grave misconduct, conduct unbecoming of a public officer, conduct prejudicial to the best interests of the service, grave abuse of authority, and violation of the code of conduct and ethical standards for public officials and employees. Those who filed the complaints are Philomena Atuel, Maria Almicar Diangson, Cybil Ibanez, and Chito de la Serna. The four of them are assigned to the City Assessor's Office. On May 17, 2023, they were transferred to a different office, but they appealed this move to the Civil Service Commission. While their appeal was pending with the CSC, they continued to report to their previous office, but from July 2023 to January 2024, they were not paid of their salaries. Aside from Rama, those also subjected to preventive suspension are the City Administrator Colleen Rosell, Officer in Charge, Office of the City Assessor Maria Teresa Rosell, Francis Mail Hakaban of the Designated Assistant Department Head, Administrative and Legal Officer Angelique Kabugao, Designated Assistant Department Head of Operations, J.R. Pescante, Designated Administrative Division Head, and Lester Joey Bediga, Designated Assessment of Records Management Division Head, and Nelim Sanrojo, the Designated Computer Division Head. The Office of the Ombudsman has also provided a copy of the department to the Department of Interior and Local Government to enforce the suspension order. Ron.
Robert Mano with that story. Thank you. The camp of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy surrenders five of its firearms to Davao Regional authorities. That's according to Interior Secretary Benner Abalos. Last month, the police revoked Quiboloy's license to own and possess firearms for 19 of his guns. Police Chief Romel Francisco Marbil says Quiboloy's camp committed to surrendering the other guns. Authorities are still searching for the fugitive pastor who's facing qualified human trafficking as well as child and sexual abuse charges.
The Philippine National Investment Fund is earmarking 2 billion pesos to upgrade the power infrastructure of Mindoro Island. This was bared Wednesday by the head of the Maharlika Funds manager, Rafael Kunsing. He says this would be among the fund's first projects since its creation in 2023. The multi-billion peso investment is seen to help connect the island to the national grid and stave off power outages similar to last year.
Our role, basically as Maharlika, is to find ways by which we can then improve. Particularly, we're going to be focusing on the lines.
Okay.
We don't need to be investing in the generation capacity because there are a number already who wish to do that. It would be in the lines that we would then invest. We will be looking at what the type of investment that is required in order to prepare Mindoro for its eventual connection into the main grid, and once that grid is connected by NGCP, then we go to the next projects.
Kunsing also bared plans for the Maharlika to help co-fund projects in healthcare and in rural connectivity. He expects these to materialize in the next 3 to 4 months.
It's a space which we think would give us both the commercial returns and at the same time being able to reach where our fellow Filipinos in terms of being able to provide them with better healthcare. Everything is absolutely connected, both on the consumption and capital formation perspective. And again, by so doing, you are also substituting what government would have spent, and in which case, reducing the possibility of a widening budget deficit.
South Korea is offering employment opportunities for female caregivers. The Department of Migrant Workers says Seoul is hiring at least 100 Filipino caregivers under an employment permit system. Eligible applicants need to be TESDA certified, have a working knowledge of the Korean language, and adequate experience. According to the DMW, South Korea came up with a program to help unburden local double-income families and achieve work and life balance.
Sa ngayon po, pilot program lang po ito para matest natin yung kung match nga po ba yung ating mga caregivers para sa kulturang Koreano. Kung kaya 100 positions lang po sa pilot test natin ang kanilang pipiliin. And depending on the assessment, baka po magkaroon at magbukas ng iba pang opportunities sa mga susunod na batches.
Sports, the top-seeded Boston Celtics dominated the Cleveland Cavaliers in Game 1 of their NBA Eastern Semifinals showdown. Jaylen Brown scored 32 points while Derek White added 25 for Boston, which pulled away in the second half. Donovan Mitchell led Cleveland with 33 points. Game 2 is Thursday night, still in Boston.